إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد أيها المسلمون أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى وطاعته كما قال في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم اتق الله حيثما كنت وأتبع سيئة الحسنة تمحها وخالق الناس بخلق حسن ثم أما بعد Brothers and sisters in Islam, a few months ago, I talked about the need of praying to Allah, invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us firm on faith. It's easy to be a Muslim now, but time will come when we will face a lot of challenges. So if you are not strong enough, you might consider recanting your faith. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would always pray to Allah to keep him faith on Islam. This is the best human being, our role model, but still he was invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep him faith on to keep him strong on Islam. And actually, in the introduction of this khutbah, I recited a verse which ends with وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ and do not die except while you are Muslims. So we also talked about the factors that can help you stay strong in your faith. And today will be the last time we talk about these factors. So another factor that can help you to keep strong in your faith is always to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In a hadith that was narrated by An-Nu'man ibn Bashir, he said, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الدُّعَاءُ هُوَ الْعِبَادَةُ The translation is, it was narrated by An-Nu'man ibn Bashir, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, supplication, invocation, dua is the foundation of worship and the basis of its strength. So the foundation of worship is dua, and the basis of the strength of worship is dua. To ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. To ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us firm on faith. To ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us away from situations that might tempt us in our faith. So when you do this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will listen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help to keep you firm on your faith. And actually, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after saying this, he quoted an ayah, a verse in the Quran. He says, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ الدَّاخِرِينَ Your Lord says, call upon me, I will answer you. Invoke me, I will answer you. Indeed, those who are disdainful in my worship, they will enter the hellfire utterly humiliated. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins with invoking him, and then he says, those who disdain his worship. So dua is a very important part of worship, is a cornerstone of worship. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, supplicating to him to keep us firm on our faith. So brothers and sisters in Islam, according to the Quran, those who are endowed with knowledge, those people who know a lot, the more they learn, the more they feel they know little, and because of this small glimpse of faith that they have, they always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep them firm on faith. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, he says, telling us about those who are grounded in knowledge, who always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep them faith, yet they know more. The more they know, the more they feel vulnerable. The more they feel they need to know more. So these knowledgeable people who fear Allah, they always pray to Allah. They always invoke Allah. What do they say? رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ. O Allah, O our Lord, solve not our hearts away from faith after guiding us, and grant us mercy from your own providence. Indeed, you are the all-granter. So those people who have knowledge, who seek to know more every day, and who are afraid to lose the faith that they have, they always supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep them on board, to keep them firm in faith in whatever circumstances they are. So this should be the attitude of a believer praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep him firm on faith. This is not something that you can take for granted. Aisha radiallahu anha told the companions of the Prophet and told us by extension, she said, كان الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يكثر من أن يقول اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلبي على دينك وطاعتك. So Aisha radiallahu anha says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would always invoke Allah, would always supplicate to Allah. What did he say? He would say, O Allah, the turner of hearts, I ask you, I beseech you to keep my heart firm on your faith and in obeying you. So this is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam who would frequently ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep him firm on faith. And this is our role model. So this, if this is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam beseeching Allah to make his faith stronger, what about me and you? We need it more than anyone else, and we need it more than ever. So we always need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with a stronger faith and to keep us stable during times of tribulations, during times of challenges, because belief won't be taken for granted. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was telling his companions about the value of paradise, he said, man khafa adlaj, whoever is afraid that he won't reach his destination on time, he will begin his journey at the beginning of the night, no matter what perils, no matter what risks he's gonna take on the way, because the destination is important to him. He will make sure he travels beforehand so that he will reach his destination on time. So he says, man khafa adlaj wa man adlaja balagha al manzil. And if you begin your journey at the beginning of the night, you will definitely reach your destination. So here, because the destination is very important to you, you don't care about what happens on the way. So the Prophet continues, ala inna sil'ata Allahi ghaliya. You should know, be aware that the commodity of Allah is very expensive. Ala inna sil'ata Allahi al-jannah. Indeed, the commodity of Allah is paradise. So you can't attain the salvation, you can't attain the bliss of paradise by wishful thinking, without working so hard, and without asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless your efforts and to strengthen your iman. So we need this dua. So the first among the factors that will make our faith stronger is to supplicate to Allah, to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our faith stronger. Even when we're going through troublesome circumstances, we're going through a lot of challenges. Another one is as-suhbah saliha, to keep pious and good friends. So choose friends which will help you to become a good believer, which will help you to grow stronger in your faith. Whether they are poor or rich, so long as they are trustworthy, so long as they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they beseech Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are honest in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, keep company with those. In a hadith that was narrated by Abu Huraira, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ar-rajulu ala dini khalilih falyanzur ahadukum man yukhalil. It was narrated by Abu Huraira that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a person among you will be influenced by the manners, by the behavior, by the religious commitment of his friend among others. So consider those things, the religious commitment, the behavior of a person before you take him as a friend. If you take as a friend a good person, a pious person, he will encourage you to worship Allah. He will encourage you to grow stronger in faith. But if you take as a friend a person who doesn't care about religion, he will discourage you from worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's very important to keep company with good friends, whether they are poor or rich, so long as they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they draw closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the qualifications: fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing whatever they do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the mushrikeen, the polytheists of Makkah, some of them on many occasions they approached the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They told him, we would like to listen to you, we would like to understand your message, but we don't like to interact with you together with the poor and the freed slaves. So their concern, especially the ringleaders of Quraysh, their concern was they wanted to learn from the Prophet according to them, but they didn't like to be associated with the poor. So they gave conditions to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that if you want us to listen to you, turn away those poor Muslims. So when we're done with you, then you can bring them back. Because we always get delegations from all over the Arabian Peninsula coming to us. So what will they see? What will they think of us when they see us interacting with the poor people, the freed slaves in front of you? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in Surah Al-An'am, وَلَا تَطْرُدِ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ. So do not turn away those who invoke their Lord, those who call upon their Lord morning and evening. So the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prevented the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to turn away those believers, even if they were poor, even if some of them were freed slaves, so long as they had the qualifications of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling upon Allah morning and evening with sincerity. They didn't have any ulterior motives. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet, don't send them away. And actually on another occasion, according to hadith that was narrated by Al-Khabbab ibn al-Arat, he said that among the ringleaders of Quraysh, Al-Aqra ibn Habis wa Uyayna ibn Husn, later on they became Muslims, but at the beginning they were among the ringleaders of Quraysh who did not entertain the idea of sitting together with the poor and the weak people in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they gave conditions to the Prophet that, you know, we always get delegations who come to us from different parts of the Arabian Peninsula, so if you like us to listen to you, just give some time for us so that we could sit around you without the poor, without those freed slaves. We alone will listen to you because we don't want people to have a bad impression about us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَلَا تَطْرُدِ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ. So do not turn away, do not chase away those who worship their Lord morning and evening. Why do they do that? They seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They seek to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So on another occasion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, patiently persevere with those around you, those poor Muslims, but who are sincere, who worship Allah, who call upon Allah morning and evening. Why? Because they seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do not turn your eyes away from them because of the allurements of this world. So the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from turning away from those poor people because some ring leaders of Quraysh had stipulated conditions on him that whenever he wanted to talk to him, he would chase away those poor believers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is admonishing him not to do that. So Abdurrahman ibn Sahl ibn Hanif says that after this verse was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went out to look for those poor people, some of them were freed slaves. So he met them somewhere while remembering Allah, supplicating to Allah, mentioning the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being sincere in their worship, remembering, believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sat with them, listened to them, he talked to them. At the end of it, he said, Alhamdulillahi alladhi ja'ala li fi ummati man amarani an usabbira nafsi ma'ahum. So the Prophet ﷺ said, I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who made for me in my ummah people who are worthy my time sitting with them, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Although those were poor people according to the standards of the society, some of them were of the low rank according to the society, but because they were sincere in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admonished the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to keep company with them, to stay with them. And actually Khabbab ibn al-Arati says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would go and sit with them, talk to them, remember Allah with them until they departed and they left him in that place. To show that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was serious in implementing this tenet of Islam of keeping company with those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are sincere in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you keep company with the good believers, they will encourage you, they will motivate you, and you will feel the delight of faith. Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu says, qala rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, thalathun man kunna fih wajada halawata al-iman, an yakuna Allah wa rasuluhu ahabba ilayhi mimma siwahuma, wa an yuhibba al-mar'a la yuhibbuhu illa lillah, wa an yakraha an ya'uda fil kufr kama yakrahu an yuqdhafa fil nar. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this hadith says that these three qualities, these three special merits, whoever has them will test the delight of faith. One of them is to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than anyone else. So your love first is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to love someone for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَنْ يُحِبَّ الْمَرْأَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. So you love someone because of Allah, not because he is a celebrity, not because you are expecting some rewards from him, not because you have ulterior motives. You love him because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And actually, among the people who will enjoy the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, وَرَجُلَانِ تَحَبَّا فِي اللَّهِ اجْتَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ وَتَفَرَّقَ عَلَيْهِ. Two men, two people who loved one another for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No ulterior motives. They were together loving one another for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they parted with one another still loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe one of them died or both of them died while they loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They didn't have any ulterior motives. So all this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are encouraging us to keep company with people who are faithful, with people who are sincere, who always remember Allah. This will boost our iman, because friendship has influence. If you have good friends, they will influence you to do good things. If you have bad friends, they will influence you to be evil. So choose those who are good, who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no matter who they are, so long as they have the qualities of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters in Islam, keeping company with good people is very important. It's very clear. You all know the story of the serial killer who killed 99 people and he wanted to repent. He went to a worshiper. The worshiper told him there is no way you could be forgiven. He killed him to complete the 100. And then he went to a scholar. A scholar told him to immigrate, to leave the village where he was, to go to another village. Why? In that village where you will go, there are righteous people worshiping Allah. So this will encourage you. The circumstances, the environment will help you to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this man advised that serial killer to leave where he was, to immigrate and go to another town where they worshiped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to keep company with good people who will always encourage him to remember Allah, who will encourage him to repent, who will give him motivation in doing good deeds. So this is among the things that will keep your iman stronger. So brothers and sisters in Islam, the last one is patience.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 153, He says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, ista'inu bis-sabri was-salah, inna Allaha ma'as-sabirin. O ye who believe, ask Allah to help you by patient perseverance and constant prayer. So you persevere, you're constant in your worship, and you pray constantly, then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you by persevering and by prayer. Indeed, Allah is with those who patiently persevere. So if you are going through dire circumstances, challenging situations, you're going through a lot of stress because of your religion, patiently persevere for the sake of Allah. Allah is with you. So this patience will keep you, it will keep you in company with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide you, and Allah will be all in all for you. This is why in Arabic we call him Rabb, which doesn't mean only Lord, it means your creator, cherisher, sustainer, provider, protector, safe haven. He's everything for you. So if you patiently persevere for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there for you. So brothers and sisters in Islam, in a hadith that was narrated by Abu Tha'laba al-Muzani, Abu Tha'laba al-Muzani was sharing with his fellow companions some of the instructions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially what the Prophet taught some of his companions about times that will come in which it will be very difficult for a believer to practice his religion. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was encouraging his companions, if such times come when it will be difficult for you to practice your religion, hang on onto your religion. Don't lose it. Don't be tempted by circumstances. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, فَإِنَّ مِنْ وَرَائِكُمْ أَيَّامُ الصَّبْرِ الصَّبْرُ فِيهِنَّ مِثْلُ الْقَبْضِ عَلَى الْجَمْرِ الصبر فيهن مثل القبض على الجمر للعامل فيهن مثل أجر 50 رجلا يعملون مثل عمله قالوا يا رسول الله أجر 50 منهم قال أجر 50 منكم. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was talking to his companions about times that will come in the future when it will be very difficult to enjoin good and forbid evil. It's an integral part of Islam when you see someone doing something wrong to advise him. But there are steps that you have to follow, not to shame someone, not to humiliate him. There are etiquettes that you have to follow to enjoin someone to do good and forbid evil. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was telling his companions that time will come when it will be extremely difficult to enjoin evil and to enjoin good and forbid evil. And time will come when it will be very difficult for any believer to exercise his religious duties. So if it so happens that you go through such times, then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, patient perseverance in doing acts of worship in such challenging circumstances will entitle you to rewards of 50 men. So you do an act of worship during such trying times, during such times which are very difficult, you get the reward of 50 people doing the same act of worship. So some of his companions asked him, أَجْرُ خَمْسِينَ مِنْهُمْ, will it be the reward equal to the reward of 50 people among the people of those times? The Prophet ﷺ said, أَجْرُ خَمْسِينَ مِنْكُمْ. So the Prophet ﷺ said, if anyone during such times when it will be very difficult to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to enjoin good and forbid evil, it will be a very big challenge. If you go out of your way, you still do good deeds, you will get the reward of 50 among the companions of the Prophet ﷺ who would have done the same act of worship. This doesn't mean that in such circumstances you will be better than the companions. Of course, ijma' al-ulama, they said that the generation of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best generation. But in this aspect, when it's very difficult, extremely difficult, yet you go out of your way, you still practice your religion, you get reward like the reward of 50 among the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was encouraging us
to still continue worshiping Allah no matter what happens to us, because Allah is all in all for us. If we are afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we fear Him, He will find a way for us. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can save us. No one else, nothing else. So in such trying times, we have always to remember Allah, to ask Him to strengthen our iman, to strengthen our faith. So brothers and sisters in Islam, there is a time when famine struck Medina, and some of the Ansar approached the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looking for provisions. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave them whatever he heard until everything was depleted. He didn't have anything more. So they continued coming to him because they were in dire need of provisions. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in a hadith that was narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, he said, وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرْهُ اللَّهُ. Whoever patiently persevere, Allah will comfort him. وَمَنْ يَسْتَغْنِي يُغْنِهِ اللَّهُ. And whoever is satisfied with what he has, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him for that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be sufficient for him. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدٌ عَطَاءً خَيْرًا وَلَا أَوْسَعْ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. And no one will be given a grant or a favor which will be better and wider than patience. So if you are given patience, this is a very big reward. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was comforting these people during tough times when they're suffering from famine. He didn't have anything extra to give them. He was exhorting them to be patient, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there for them. Don't lose hope. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there for you. As I said before, in a hadith that was narrated by Abu Huraira in Sahih al-Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, man yuridillahu bihi khayran yusab minhum. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends good, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends to confer prosperity on someone, He will first try him. So you first go through a lot of tribulations, problems. So it depends on how you react in such a time. If you react positively, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there for you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will compensate for you, and the doors of success will be opened to you. So brothers and sisters in Islam, if we want our faith to grow stronger, first dua, supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Two, keep company with pious people. Three, be patient. This will be the last, as I said, the last time we talk about the factors, and next time we'll talk about other things. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim, wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bil ayat wa dhikr al-hakim, aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-azim li wa lakum. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was informing his companions about tribulations that will happen in the future. He said, in the future there will come a lot of fitan, a lot of trying circumstances, a lot of trials and tribulations. So a person will be stricken with calamities, and he will feel that this is his end. I'm going to die. I won't survive it. Then he will survive it by the grace of Allah. Then another calamity will strike. Then he will survive it. At the end of the hadith, a very long hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, فَمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يُزَحْزَحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَيَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَلِتَأْتِهِ مَنِيَّتُهُ وَهُوَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَلْيَأْتِ إِلَى النَّاسِ الَّذِي يُحِبُّ أَنْ يُؤْتَى إِلَيْهِ. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, therefore, if anyone wants to stay far away from the hellfire, then he should make sure that his death comes when he is still believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day, and he should treat people the way he would like to be treated. So continue believing in Allah, continue worshiping Allah until your death, and make sure you treat your fellow human beings the way you would like to be treated. Not only should you treat well the human beings, all creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa sallu wa sallimu ala man umirtum bis salati wa salam alayhi, umuman bi qawlihi ta'ala, inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad,
كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ورضى اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجمعين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت ولا ينفع ذا الجد منك الجد ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا رخاء سخاء وسائر بلاد المسلمين اللهم لا تجعل في يومنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرت ولا هما إلا فرجت ولا كربا إلا فرجت ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا إلا قضيتها يا أرحم الراحمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.